Oh man, what's going on now? It's me versus her.
Hello, Mumsy.
Muty. I might have known this was something to do with you.
What is going on?
You can't trust a word this boy says. He's tricked you.
Uh-oh. I thought there was something weird with Newton.
Lovely baby.
Oh, come on, Mumsy. It's time they were released. Imagine what we can do with all that creativity.
Never. Don't you remember what your father said? You must never, ever... open the lid!
Oh, gosh, no. What have we done? This is our doing. We let Newton get to this point.
What have you done? Bunker will be ruined!
No! Newton, why?
Ruined? No, 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 no. With the Titans under our control, we can make Bunker the happiest, jolliest picnic spot in the whole Imagisphere. And I couldn't have done it without you, old chum.
Dang you, Newton!
Titans, let us make Bunkum! Bunkum! Oh, oh, I threw!
Oh gosh! They're turning on him!
Sorry, Bunkum. Slight change of plan. I think I will destroy you instead! Farewell, dear friend!
No! And we make our descent down? No! I don't have wings! This isn't good at all. The Titans have possessed Newton. Now where are we? Unconscious on the ground. Ow, oh no, we're getting up. We're tough, but there's stuff falling from above. No, your house.
What have you done? Leading my Newty astray? Poor Newty. He never done no one no harm. He don't know no better. You got to save him from himself. And on the way, you'll save Bunkum too. Come on, follow me.
All right then, we owe it to Bunkum to fix what we've done wrong.
You can't defeat the Titans by yourself. Look at you. I've seen more muscle on a jelly deal. You'll need to awaken Bunkum's old heroes. Oddsock, Toggle, and Swoop.
Oh boy, I can't wait. See, some good is coming out of this.
It won't be easy, but your quest begins in Manglewood, Bunkum's great swamp.
Phew. That was rather exciting, eh? Quite the thrill ride, I think you'd agree. Oh, and what's this? It's a map. Maps are terrific, aren't they? And LittleBigPlanet maps 10 times terrifica. And that isn't even a word. Imagine that. Use the left stick to pick your destination and tap the action button to visit it. You'll notice some locked badges along the way. Don't worry, you'll get the measure of those lads as your adventure unfolds. Come on then, let all the wonderful things that can possibly happen start happening.
Wowee, so after like 4 episodes, we're finally at the pod. And I just want to take a look around. I feel like we owe it to ourselves to take a look at the pod.
You're back and precisely on time. We've just made the finishing touches, and your arrival signifies the grand unveiling of, well, everything. Don't be shy. Toddle up to the pod computer and tap on the menu button to see just what's on offer. Hold on to your socks. We weren't fibbing when we said we were going to blow them right off.
Oh, man. I'm excited. So, we can bring our stuff back, but we did that already because I am an impatient little striped mammal. But okay, we can bring some of this stuff back. That's okay, though, because if we take a look here, we'll get all the cool stuff we already have. We have tons of it. Tons and tons and tons of it. And we're getting pins and pins and pins. I love it so much. We even have some stickers, too. We could start decorating our pod a little bit if we wanted to. Maybe put something silly in here. I don't know. We have plenty of stuff. But yeah, this is, of course, in our story mode series, so we won't be doing too much out of the stray, but of course I just wanted to sort of check this out a little bit. Of course, you know, it would be fun, would it be cool? It's, ooh, maybe we could put some concept art. The choices are all here. There is so much we could do. I gotta pick something. I gotta pick at least one thing to put on our pod. What could it be? It has to be something cool. I usually like putting the record button on, but I can't quite find it. Maybe just a happy face to express how happy I am to be playing this game. Cool, so as the time goes on, we will continue decorating our pod. Feel free to let me know if there's any type of specific sticker decoration or anything like that you would like to see in the pod. I'd love to hear you guys in the comment section below.
3, 2, 1, and there you are. I win. To explain, we had a little lottery about the exact moment you'd arrive, and I, most cleverly, calculated it down to the exact nanosecond. Nanoseconds are like nanoseconds, except they're much older, and with fewer teeth. You've found yourself in sack form at the controls of your pod computer, the stick-shaped steering wheel of your own personal pod. Use the left stick to navigate and the action button to select the things that tickle your fancy. You can detach yourself from the device by pressing the back button, by the way.
Okay, I'd like to appreciate how zen this is. The nice music, the simple layout. It's just like we have the store, the play, the meet, and it looks so good. It feels so good. It's awesome.
Play is the place to be when you want to fight off boredom with a soft, woolly sack person's touch. There's loads to do. Some say maybe too much. There's poppet puzzles that test your brain as well as your dexterous hands. And of course, there is our grandest ever adventure to try out. And if you've purchased things from the Little Big Planet store, well, you'll find them in more stories. If that's not enough, then open the door to the community, where you'll find trillions of Brill levels made by enterprising, attractive folk like yourself. There's never a dull minute round here.
Very cool. Of course, we'll be continuing our adventure, though. That's what we're in here for.
Welcome back, brave woolen adventurer. Ready for the great and thrilling journey through Bunker Mayu? What twists and turns await you? Who can say? Not me. And not Susan, either. She's a cat, you understand. And I don't think a meow or a purr is sufficient to describe what wonders could be next.
Okay then, so if we look around, this is the prologue. We finished all 5 levels here.
You've got to love maps. Who hasn't placed a map of the world on the floor and stomped around it making giant monster sounds? But seriously, maps are terrific. The ones up here, doubly so. The map is the epicenter of adventure. Somewhere you'll visit regularly if I know you. Use the left stick to pick your destination and the action button to visit it. Don't worry about all the locked badges. You'll gain access to these as you play. So much to see and do, I'm quite giddy with excitement. Where's that world map? I'm a-going stomping.
I have to agree with him. I'm also giddy with excitement, so why don't we head into Book 1, Manglewood. The structure seems a little different this time, but I like it so far. So it looks like we can head into the main hub area. Let's head into Manglewood Swamp. Okay, then, we're on our boat.
We're lost. Lost! We'll never save Buncombe at this rate.
Oh, no. Uh-oh, we're stopping, too.
Wait. I've got it. The Organizer-tron will save us. Here, take this.
Cool.
And listen.
When there's a laundry list of things to do as long as both your arms, it's time to call in some help. Whenever the guardians of the small, huge sphere have a task for you, the Organizer-tron kindly jots it down for you. Hold down the triangle button to open it up, and from there, you can check on your have-dones and yet-to-dos using your left stick. A press of the action button lets you examine the ins and outs of your chosen activity, and you can even get handy pointers on where you need to go by pressing the menu button. It's awfully useful like that. As always, a quick tap of the back button will close the Organizer-tron, letting you skip back off to do whatever it is you do when you think we're not looking.
Okay, then.
Now, open your Organizer-tron and track the quest with the menu button.
Awesome. So, what button do we press again? Instantly forget. That's the zebra way.
Open the Organizer-tron and track the quest.
Uh-oh. I forget what button it is. I honestly forget. There we go. I have to hold triangle down. This is so cool because I love the Organizer-tron. That's gonna be hard to say to get used to at first, but I can't wait to see some of the levels and just different community things that come out of the Organizer-tron. But search for Marlin Random, find Marlin Random in Manglewood Swamp. So much tongue twisters, they love those. Okay, then now we know exactly where to go. Cool. Oh man, this is spooky.
So this is Manglewood. This filthy swamp was once home to Buncombe's thriving film industry. Have a word with Marlon Random. He's gone a bit bonkers, but he knows what's what. With Oddsock on your side, you can stop those horrible titans and bring back my newty.
So it looks like these films are rather washed up. Get it? Because it's in a swamp? Zebra jokes? Hashtag Zebratastic. Alright then, it looks like we're making our way towards the swamp now. Ooh, I love this, like, green sort of, almost like a, type of, like scales on the ground. I like that. It's cool. This is some pretty spooky stuff, though. Okay, then maybe we can. Maybe we can do something here. Maybe we can like bring that towards us and get up there. Not looking like it. I wonder how we're gonna get up there. Some interesting stuff all over the place, but we seem to just not be able to reach most of it. But I mean, that might be the point that it is in a hub, which I'll get into, I guess, momentarily. Whoa, look at the Oddsock shine.
Winning smile. Dramatic pause. Marlon Random is the name. Method acting is the game. Come on, baby, bring it closer. Closer. That's it. Beautiful. Camera never lies. How you doing, Cloth Kid? Looking for Oddsock, huh? Well, you're gonna need to find Oddsock's three marbles first. When the Titans were defeated, the great heroes lost their motivation. Soon, they lost their marbles, too, and retreated into their sanctuaries. They haven't been seen since.
Oh,
over
no.
Time, the marbles were forgotten by all but Buncombe's oldest and wisest, and coolest. Lucky for you, old Marlon Random knows where they are. One's in the heavily guarded fort. We're gonna have to do that one real quiet-like. One is in the dark heart of the Imagisphere. One sits in the boughs of a great tree. You need to branch out to find it. When you find a marble, it will fly back to its place on the shrine gate. Find all three, and the gate will open. Don't worry, kid. I'll be on hand to direct you.
Fantastic. So, one of the cool things about LittleBigPlanet 3 is now there is now hubs for each area. So basically, we can go and find the level within this area, and that'll be the level to play. It's very cool. A little hard to explain, but at the same time, so exciting. It's something I've been actually really floored to see, and it's really cool to see it in action. We're able to adventure this small area, get some collectibles, and even find some fun levels to play. Like, there's one right here. What is this?
Oh, you have the look of a discerning fashionista. I am Zoom Zoom, and this is Zoom Zoom's Fashion Emporium. I'm sure your keen eye has spotted the collectibles littered around Buncombe. Pick them up and bring them here and spend them in my store. We have fabulous bargains to suit every taste and budget inside. So don't delay. Come to Zoom Zoom's Fashion Emporium today.
Interesting. So one of the new collectibles are these collectibles. We can pick these up and we get five of them. Let's head into Zoom Zoom's shop then.
Oh, come in, come in. Everything is for sale.
Okay then, so can we
Welcome! Zoom Zooms is always open to shoppers with a discerning eye like your own. Buy five items and receive a magical free gift! Terms and conditions apply.
Okay then, so one of the cool things about LittleBigPlanet 3 is that it's a little offbeat compared to other LittleBigPlanet games. Alright, so we can browse stuff. But basically, In LittleBigPlanet 1 and 2, if you go to a new area, they'll give you a whole bunch of new costumes related to that area. Here it's a little different. If you want one costume more than the other, you can buy it right away, and that way you get a choice, and it's so cool. But yeah, we use these collectibles to buy all the costumes we want. Right now we only have 5, which means we can probably only buy about one. Oh, it's an elephant Oddsock. Bringing up that jungle fever, I guess. I can either get the zebras, elephants, giraffes, what else can you get here? Okay, no, get a lot of Oddsocks. I love the pug. I absolutely love the pug. That's 20 collectibles, though. Alright, then. If we have to choose something here, I think that I would like to choose... I'm gonna go with the wolf, I think. The wolf is pretty cool. Do I have enough for this? Yes, I do.
Accessorize in style with a feather for purchases.
Very, very cool. So now if I press square, I can go to the customize... Alright then, and where is it? Hopefully somewhere near, rather than far. Let's get to the outfits and go to newest, and let's check it out. Here we go, the regal wolf costume. Fantastic. Look at me, I'm a wolf, but I'd rather be a zebra, so let's go back on, whoa. Check this out, we can also be the Nana Pud. So we can just be the game characters, which is really, really cool. Hey there! Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and sharing it with your friends and family. The support really does help. If you have any thoughts, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. If you're interested in watching more videos, why don't you check out some of the ones on the screen right now? Either way, this has been Zebra. Thank you guys so much for watching, and stay Zebratastic.